To this end, I met with the Lieutenant Governor earlier today and asked that we prorogue the House so that we can pursue both discussions, both tracks, in a way that is free of the heightened rancor that has sadly too frequently characterized our legislature of late. So, when the House returns, we're going to either have negotiated agreements in hand or a legislative plan supported by the opposition. Now, let me say a few words to you about you. This caucus is the most talented, hardworking, and dedicated group of people I've ever had the opportunity to work with. Every single day you keep proving yourselves. And I'm very, very grateful for all the support that you've given me. We've come a long way together. We've made tremendous progress in getting Ontario back on track in the only race it should ever compete in, and that's the race to the top. Now, as the party and as a government, which has committed itself to making relentless progress, we're always looking for new ideas. We're always looking for ways to renew ourselves. So this is how I see it. Are you ready for this? After 16 years as leader of the Ontario Liberal Party, and after 9 years as Premier, it's time for renewal. It's time for the next Liberal Premier. It's time for the next set of Liberal ideas to guide our province forward. To that end, a moment ago, I spoke with the President of our party, Yasser Naqvi. I've asked that he convene a leadership convention at the earliest possible opportunity. It will be my honour to continue to serve you and Ontarians as Premier until such time as our party's elected a new leader who's been sworn in. Rid of me so easily. I'm also committed to continuing to serve the good people of Ottawa South as their MPP until the next general election, so I will remain with you. I want to take a few moments and say a few things to the good people of Ontario. It has been my great honor and huge privilege to serve you as your Premier. I have sometimes asked of you hard things, but I've always been inspired by this ideal that the older generations work as hard as they can to build a bright future for the younger ones. I saw that in my own mother and father. It's what Terry and I have tried to do for our own children, and I see it in the eyes and actions of Ontario families every single day. So I thank you for this great honor of serving as Premier here in Ontario. It truly is the greatest province and the best country in the world. Thank you.